Let's discuss the electric field due to a large uniformly charged sheet by using Gauss' law. So if there is a large uniformly charged sheet which is having a charge per unit area on the surface sigma coulomb per meter square, and say due to the sheet in front of it at a point P, we are required to find the electric field, for which certainly we need to consider Gaussian surface if we wish to apply Gauss' law. And the Gaussian surface must be considered in such a way that first point is this point P must lie on the Gaussian surface, and that every point of Gaussian surface either electric field would be parallel or perpendicular to the surface. And here by symmetry we can say we consider a cylindrical Gaussian surface which is passing through the sheet and extended exactly to the same point which is say P dash at the other side of the sheet, and the cylindrical surface is say of length L, and we consider it is of face area S. Now in this situation by symmetry we can say whatever electric field E exists at point P, by symmetry the same electric field will exist at point P dash. And we can divide this Gaussian surface into three parts, 1, 2 and 3, where 1 and 3 are the circular faces of the cylindrical section and 2 is the lateral surface of the cylinder. So in this situation, we can say for the section 2, area vector at any point ds vector will be perpendicular to the surface, and due to the sheet electric field will be parallel to the surface. Whereas for 1 and 3, always the area vector and electric field vector are in same direction here we can see. So, if we apply Gauss' law on this surface, which we can name as M. So, we can say using Gauss' law on surface M, we apply integration of E dot ds for the surface M is equal to the net enclosed charge by epsilon naught. Now if we talk about the net enclosed charge, the total area of the surface is S and the surface charge density on the sheet is sigma. So we can see that the total charge enclosed will be sigma S. So this can be written as sigma S by epsilon naught. And if we split this integral, it can be written as integral of first part E dot ds plus integral for the second part E dot ds plus the integral E dot ds for the third part. And here you can see that for the second part E and ds are perpendicular, so this integral will vanish and the only parameter left will be the first and third integral. And by symmetry we can see at every point of the surface S on both of these sections 1 and 3, the electric field will be uniform. So this E can be taken out of the integral and integration of ds can be written as total area S. So these two will be added as 2ES, which will be equal to sigma S by epsilon naught, and here S also gets cancelled out and the electric field will be sigma by 2 epsilon naught, which is a very important result you always need to keep in mind, which we also calculated by the integral of elemental electric field due to a point charge. And here you can see the electric field remain uniform everywhere in the surrounding if the charge is uniformly distributed on the sheet as surface charge density sigma. In the next section we'll study that in similar way, we can find out the electric field due to a conducting sheet on which the charge will split on two surfaces, front as well as rear. That will continue in the next section.